in the previous session, that is from French Revolution, we have learned about the revolutionaries have stormed Bastille, which is a fortress prison, and we have also learned what are the reasons, what are the circumstances that made them to storm the Bastille. And today, that is from page number 8 to 11, we are going to learn about the immediate cause of the revolution, that is the outbreak of the revolution. There are several circumstances from the past, that is from centuries together, they have faced the problem of the division in the society, the tax structure, made them a lot of problem for all the revolutionaries and all the people of France, that is during or before 1789, during 18th century. So what is the immediate cause of the revolution? With what immediate cause the revolution actually broke? We have already learnt during the 18th century the king was Louis XVI. So he made a proposal to increase the taxes. So there is a system which is followed in France. He alone cannot take the decision. He needs to call the estate general. So what is meant by estates general? Estates general is a political body. In the previous class we have learned that there are three estates. First estate, second estate and third estate. So first estate is clergy, church officials. Second estate is nobility, that is kings. And all the manual labor, they are included in the third estate. So the king called a political body, that is on 5th May 1789. That is which consists of three estates. And now he wanted to lay the proposal of new taxes, calling the estate general. So this estate general, it is composed of 300 representatives each from first estate and second estate, and 600 members from the third estate. So 300 representatives each means from first estate 300 members, second estate 300 members, and from the third estate 600 members. So like how in India we have a parliament, like that they are having a hall, a very big hall at Versailles, which is in France. So in that a very big hall which is a mirror hall, so all they used to sit in rows. That is first estate and second estate used to face each other. They used to sit in a row facing each other, 300 members each. Whereas the 600 members from the third estate have to stand at the back. So that shows the inequality. They are not allowed to sit. Only the first estate, second estate had a privilege of sitting and discussing about the proposal as set by the Louis XVI about the new taxes. So what is the tax structure? As we have already learned in the previous class, what is the tax structure that used to be followed in France? That is the poor have to pay more tax than the rich. So the gap between the rich and the poor has been widened. So now by laying a new tax, the gap will be more widened. What is our tax structure in India? Our tax structure in India, it is the more they earn, the more they have to pay the tax. But that is different in France. That made them a lot of pain. That is the reason they started the revolution. So now the king laid the proposal of the new taxes, calling the estate general. Estate general. So we have learnt about the composition of the first estate, second estate and the third estate. Now when the king laid the proposal to increase the new taxes, first estate, second estate will give a positive response. They will say yes. Why? They need not pay the tax. The burden of tax is for whom? The third estate. So they will say no. So, as first estate and second estate is getting more, the majority wins. Both are having 600 members, 600 members. But if some members did not attend, so the proposal which is laid by the king will be accepted as the majority wins. So, that is the reason this type of composition they have followed. And next, they used to follow a system that the third category of the third estate. In third estate, we have an educated group, as I told you before, and also we are having a non-prosperous section of the society or less prosperous section of the society. So they are peasants, artisans, and women are also denied to enter into the hall. So only men about 25 years are allowed to enter, and the other category people, the less prosperous section of the society, they have to stay, that is out of the hall only. They have to write letters and then submit to the National Assembly. So they were denied to enter into the hall. So there is an inequality there. And they used to follow a method that is centuries together, one old method they used to follow, that is each estate will have one vote. Each estate will have one vote, that is the old method they have followed. Now the demand of the third estate is each member should get one vote. So if each estate is getting one vote, majority wins. Each estate one vote means first estate, second estate will always be in favor of the king. So two votes and third estate will say no. So which one will win? The majority wins. So that is the reason third estate people demanded each member should get one vote. But the king rejected the demand. When the king rejected the demand, all the third estate people walked out of the assembly. And they started a meeting, that is on the outside of the assembly in an open tennis court. They started a meeting and started having a big procession, which was led by Meenakshi and Agassiz in the indoor tennis court, which is outside the hall. So that was led by Meenakshi and Agassiz. So who is this Meenakshi and who is this Agassiz? Meenakshi is from a noble family, and he gave powerful speeches about the third estate because he came to understand what is the miserable condition of the third estate, that is about the tax structure. And Agassiz was a priest. So Meenakshi belongs to nobility, Agassiz belongs to clergy. He is a priest. Professionally he is a priest, and he wrote a book called What is the Third Estate? And that turned into a very big pamphlet, and have been distributed to all among the members of the third estate. So third estate got a support from clergy as well as nobility. So the procession, the revolution became very strong. And on 4th August 1789, when the revolution started increasing its strength, they have passed a decree. Decree means order. So what is meant by an order? See, our government also, if they want to implement, they will implement a decree which can also be called as a GO, government order. So what is that order is, the feudal system and taxes have been abolished. Because the revolution is becoming stronger, it is gaining its strength, as many nobles as well as church authorities, church officials also started supporting the third estate, understanding the miserable condition of the third estate. So feudal system has been cancelled. So feudal system is what, children, we have learnt in the previous class, that the society has been divided into three estates: first estate, second estate and third estate. Now all the people, the privilege is not given by the birth, it is given through merit. So feudal system has been abolished, and the taxes, new taxes, king wants to lay a proposal of new taxes, that also has been abolished. And next, we have learned in the previous class that two types of taxes they used to pay. One is tithe, which is 1/10 of the produce, and the second one is taille. The two taxes has been abolished after the decree has been passed on 4th August 1789. So now let us learn about France becomes a constitutional monarchy. Monarchy means what? Ruled by the king, where he is having absolute power. That is the legislature making law, implementing the law, that is executing the law, and next maintaining the law, like what our courts will do the work. So the three powers are vested in the hands of one person, that is called as monarchy. So now Louis XVI is holding the power. So now France becomes a constitutional monarchy. Means king alone used to take his decision. That is despotism. So now he has to decide according to the constitution which was drafted by the National Assembly after this decree is passed. So now the important event which happened in the year 1791 is France became a constitutional monarch. So the king has to rule according to the constitution. from 1791 onwards. So the king agreed for that. So now the constitution have declared that the power should be distributed between legislature, executive and judiciary. But the people who are elected to the legislature, they were elected only by the active citizens. So who are these active citizens? Active citizens means men above 25 years. Women are denied to vote. And next, men below 25 years, because of their age limit, they are not allowed. So men above 25 years and taxpayers are only allowed to vote to elect the legislature. Next, so who are passive citizens? Women, men below 25 years and non-taxpayers are considered as passive citizens. They are not allowed to vote. Denied means they are not allowed to vote. So here again there is an inequality. Off late, we learn in the next chapter that off late women, because of their revolution, then they have attained right to vote. That we will learn it later. What revolution they started and how they got that right. So now in 1791, what is the change has been brought in France when they have declared constitutional monarchy is the society has been divided into active citizens and passive citizens because feudal system is abolished. So now first estate, second estate, third estate has been abolished. Now the society we have active citizens, passive. So passive means men below 25 years, women and non-taxpayers. Active citizens means men above 25 years and taxpayers. So they are only allowed to vote. They are denied or not allowed to vote. And some rights have been declared. So 1791 constitution, they have drafted it. They have completed in the year 1791. And some rights have been declared to all the citizens of the France. So what are these rights called as? These rights are called as natural and inalienable rights. So what is this natural and inalienable rights? The rights which we acquire by birth. It's not that the government will give the rights and take away the rights, because governments keep on changing. Because who are elected, they will come to the power. So one government may give the right and one government may take away the rights. It's not like that. Natural and inalienable rights means the rights which we acquire by birth. So what are these rights, sir, which we acquire by birth? That is the right to life. And next one is freedom of speech. And next is freedom of opinion. And next is equality before law. So these four rights were not given before these rights were declared in France, that is in the year 1791. So before 1791, people are not allowed to speak. Whatever king orders, they have to follow. If they are not following, if they will go against or if they will oppose, they are punished to death. Their heads were beheaded. They were beheaded. So 1791, one of the important fruit after the French Revolution is natural and inalienable rights have been declared. They were given liberty. They were given equality, as there was no equality before 1791. So the fruits what we all are enjoying now, we have right to speak. We have right to give our opinion. We are equal before the law. See, at that time they are not equal before the law. The first estate is different, second estate is different. They were not punished by the law. But whereas the third estate is punished by the law. So now these rights are very important. As I told you before, one of the important thing why we are learning about French Revolution is the rights, the ideas which are born out of French Revolution inspired Europe, all other countries, not only Europe, all other countries in the world, including India. So these rights are one of the important fruits of 1791 revolution. So now after this rights has been declared, that is we have learnt about before storming of Bastille, that is on 14th July 1789, as the king laid the proposal. All the people, they revolted, they went outside that indoor tennis court, which was led by Mirabeau and Agassiz. And next, they have stormed Bastille, not only storming Bastille, they have stormed and destroyed manor. Manor means landlord's residence, it's a French word. And next, they have also destroyed ripe crops, already which is ready for harvest. so that crops have been destroyed. That is the crops belonging to landlords. And next, chetaks. Chetaks means the residence or the castle of the noble people, king's houses or king's residences. And they also burnt all the documents. What are the documents means? Suppose one person is taking a loan of 1,000 rupees. They used to write 1 lakh rupee because they don't know how to read and write. Such all documents have been burnt. So all such things have been done by all the revolutionaries. So the revolution became very strong, and because of that strong revolution only they could enjoy the fruit of the revolution of 1791. But still women were not given right to vote. In our next session we will be learning about how they fought and acquired right to vote.